गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 11, दिस इज योर सब्जेक्ट अकाउंटेंसी, चैप्टर नंबर 11, कैश बुक, लेक्चर नंबर 4। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सॉल्व टिल क्वेश्चन नंबर 7। लेट्स स्टार्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 थे ऑफ कैश बुक। दिस इज गिवन इन योर बुक ऑन पेज नंबर 11.58। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। In the cash book with cash and bank columns. See, here are some entries. You read the question carefully. Later on, we'll go on. Yes, beta. Our first entry is on 1st April 2016. It is balance is given cash in hand and cash at bank. So two balance BD, cash mein jayega 2000 and bank mein 12000 will go. Fine. On April 3rd received cash from Madhav 1800. Definitely it will be in receipt side, that will be debit side. So April 3rd Madhav to Madhav account. And cash में under cash we will write 1800. Fine. On April 5th cash sale is there for rupees 1000. So 5th April two sales account 1000 under cash. On April 6th purchases by check 745. By purchases account. क्रेडिट साइड पे एंड चेक के थ्रू किया है, दैट्स व्हाई दिस अमाउंट विल गो अंडर बैंक कॉलम। फाइन। ऑन अप्रैल 9 पेड इनटू बैंक 1850। पेड इनटू बैंक मींस आई टोल्ड यू अर्लियर एज वेल बेटा, इट विल बी कॉन्ट्रा एंट्री। फाइन। टू कैश अकाउंट बाय बैंक अकाउंट, टू कैश अकाउंट कॉन्ट्रा एंट्री लेजर फोलियो में सी, बैंक में 1850 रुपीज। By bank account LF में C and cash में 1850 rupees. Fine. Whenever any contra entry is there, definitely in both the sides cash and bank column will be fulfilled. Whether cash account is there, then it will be written under bank. If bank account is there, it will be written under cash. And in front of both under ledger folio column, we will write C as per contra entry. Fine. Now on April 10, paid cash for freight 54 rupees by freight account 54 under cash. April 12, drew from bank for office use 600. So on April 12, both the accounts are used, cash and bank both. So drew from bank, that will be to bank account by cash account. To bank account amount will be in cash, by cash account amount will be in bank and contra entries. That's why we will write C. Fine. On April 13, issued a check in favor of Messrs. Arun and Sons for rupees 985. By Messrs. Arun and Sons 985 check issue kiya hai. That's why we will write under bank. Bank ke niche likhi hai. Bank column mein. Fine. Now after 13-16 paid into bank 715 rupees. Paid into bank means it means that we have deposited cash into our bank account. Fine. So according to asset rule, increase is in the asset is debited and decrease in the asset is credited. So cash deposited in the bank, it means cash is decreases and bank is increases. That's why we will have to increase the bank balance, isn't it so? So the entry will be to cash account by bank account. It is contra entry, that's why we write C. To cash likhenge, to bank ke niche amount likhenge. By bank likhenge, to cash ke niche amount likhenge. Fine. It should be like this. Next entry is ड्रू कैश फॉर हिज सन्स बर्थडे पार्टी 175 rupees. तो इट इज ड्रॉइंग, तो दैट्स वाई बाय ड्रॉइंग. फाइन, कैश निकाला इसलिए क्या करेंगे हम, बाय ड्रॉइंग, सो इट विल बी रिटन अंडर कैश कॉलम. फाइन, नेक्स्ट वन इज रिसीव्ड अ चेक फ्रॉम नवीन फॉर ₹380 एंड डिपॉजिट इन टू बैंक इन ऑन द सेम डे. 380 का चेक मिला नवीन से, तो टू नवीन अकाउंट एंड बैंक के अंडर जाएगा ₹380. फाइन, ऑन अप्रैल 20th कैश सेल्स 200, तो टू सेल्स अकाउंट ₹200 अंडर कैश. 25th ड्रू फ्रॉम बैंक फॉर ऑफिस यूज ₹200, सो ड्रू फॉर फ्रॉम बैंक फॉर ऑफिस यूज, दैट्स व्हाई इट विल बी कॉन्ट्रा एंट्री, इजंट इट सो. सो इट विल बी टू बैंक अकाउंट बाय कैश अकाउंट ₹200 व्हेन बाय कैश अकाउंट ₹200 अंडर बैंक व्हेन बैंक अकाउंट इज देयर ₹200 अंडर कैश. फाइन, अप्रैल 26 परचेज फर्नीचर फॉर 1000 एंड पेमेंट मेड बाय चेक. फर्नीचर खरीदा और पेमेंट की चेक से, तो बाय फर्नीचर अकाउंट एंड बैंक से अमाउंट चली जाएगी, तो ₹1000 बैंक कॉलम में लिखेंगे. अप्रैल 27 नवीन चेक डिसऑनर्ड, नवीन का चेक जो है वो डिसऑनर हो गया बेटा. फाइन, और ₹5 बैंक चार्जेस भी लगे हैं, तो नवीन के लिए हमने एंट्री की थी टू नवीन अकाउंट, बैंक में अमाउंट गई थी, डिसऑनर हो गया तो अपोजिट एंट्री कर देंगे बाय नवीन अकाउंट, और 380 में ₹5 ऐड करेंगे जो हमारा बैंक चार्जेस हैं, और अमाउंट आएगी 385, इट विल बी रिटर्न अंडर बैंक. फाइन, नेक्स्ट वन इज परचेज बिजनेस प्रीमिसेस पेमेंट मेड बाय चेक 12,000, तो बाय बिजनेस प्रीमिसेस 12,000 अंडर बैंक. ऑन 30th रिसीव चेक फॉर 675 फ्रॉम हरीश, तो टू हरीश बैंक के अंडर लिखेंगे 675. नाउ वी विल टोटल इट अप बोथ द कॉलम्स एंड डेफिनेटली द कॉलम ऑफ बैंक इज डेबिटेड इज शॉर्टर देन द कॉलम ऑफ बैंक क्रेडिटेड, सो इट विल बी लाइक ₹295 टू बैलेंस सीडी एंड देयर विल बी कैश बैलेंस विल बी लैकिंग बिहाइंड from debit side, so it will be by balance CD 3006. Cash ka balance yahan aa jayega debit side mein aur bank ka balance jo hai wo aapka credit side mein aa jayega. Fine, by balance BD May 1st, my by balance BD May 1st. Under cash it will be 3006 and under bank will be 295 rupees. Understood this question? Now see, there is working note. Did not have any specific check deposit date. अगर आपको deposit date नहीं दी हो तो ये assume करेंगे कि check जो है वो same date पे deposit हुआ है. Fine. Now question number 8B. See beta, enter the following transaction in the cash book with cash and bank column. Now it is again double column cash book. So how will do that? Let's see. June 1st cash in hand and bank overdraft. So bank overdraft is given, that's why it is by balance BD. So it amount will be written under bank column. And cash in hand is there, so to balance BD the amount will be written under cash column. Let's see. See beta. So June 1st, same entry will be there on both the side that I told you. June 7, received a check from Bharti 3250. So it could be checks in hand because we did not consider it that it is deposited into the bank, isn't it so? Because beta, आपको पूरी entries पढ़नी है. देखिए अप्रैल सॉरी जून 15 को मार्च चेक भारतीय चेक डिसऑनर लिखा हुआ है, तो इसलिए हमने ये अज्यूम ही नहीं किया कि चेक जो है वो बैंक में डिपॉजिट कराया है. फाइन, सो इट विल बी टू चेक्स इन हैंड 3250 इन बैंक. फाइन, एंड ऑन सेम डेट एंट्री विल बी देयर चेक्स इन हैंड टू अकाउंट डेबिटेड टू भारतीय अकाउंट. फाइन, on 9th this check is deposited into the bank. That's why I have done this entry on 9th. Two checks in hand account. Otherwise, this entry we will do in working note, checks in hand account debited to Bharti. Fine. Now see, deposited this is done June 12 paid to Bhavna by check. Bhavna ko pay kiya check ke through, to by Bhavna's account. And 2,425 will be in bank account. Under bank account, we will write. On June 15, Bharti's check dishonored. Bharti ka check dishonored ho gaya, to by Bharti, here 3,250 rupees. Fine. Under bank. Next one is beta June 20th withdrew from bank for office use. That means it's withdrew from bank for office use. That means it will be contra entry. So to bank account by cash account, to bank account 250 in cash, by cash account 250 will be in bank. On June 25th, check received from Pannalal and those in the favor of Kamal on 28th June. On June 25th, check received. So, as you know, you can prepare one working note. Received and endorsement of check will not be entered in cash book as it is done through general proper. Means a lot of entries are to be done in working notes. Fine. So June 30th, income tax paid by check 150 rupees. So it is by drawings account 150 rupees under bank. June 30th, bank charges are there 4 rupees 25. So by bank charges 25 rupees in bank. Now we will have to do balance of both the sides. So whatever the balance will be there will carry down and brought down in the very first day only. On the very first day in the next month. Fine. So here bank balance will be carried forward under 8,550 rupees. And cash balance will be carried forward 1,050 rupees. Now see working notes beta. First of all, June 7, checks in hand account debited to Bharti's account. Received check from Bharti. Fine. On June 25th, checks in hand account debit to Pannalal's account. Hame Pannalal se check mila, to uski hame entry karni hai working note mein. That will be 1,200. Fine. On June 28th, ye bol rahe hai, Kamal jo hai, चेक जो है कमल के फेवर में हमने एंडोर्स कर दिया, तो कमल अकाउंट डेबिटेड टू चेक्स इन हैंड, दैट विल बी 1,200 बिकॉज एज यू नो द रिसीव्ड एंड एंडोर्समेंट ऑफ चेक विल नॉट बी एंटर्ड थ्रू कैश बुक, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज रिकॉर्डेड थ्रू वर्किंग नोट्स. फाइन. सो दिस दीज वर द क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू cash and bank column, means double column cash book. So your homework is you have to do till question number 8B and practice the illustration given in your book on page number 11.23 and 11.21. basically it is 11.21 to 11.24. fine. It's your homework beta. You have to solve both the questions along with the illustration given in your book. Illustration 8A and 8B both. So that you can practice about the entries also. Whatever is done is to be done in working note. And one more thing beta, whatsoever working note you are preparing that is related to question, means in question you were not capable to do that entry, that's why you have prepared these working notes. Okay, so it is very much necessary to prepare working note whenever you are doing entries. Understood? दैट्स फाइन फॉर टुडे.